What's up, guys? Today we're going to move on to sound waves, and we are going to talk about the resonance for sound waves in a tube open at just one end using nodes and antinodes. All right, so if you're not sure exactly what nodes and antinodes are, go back and look at my last video. I'll leave a card in the top right now. You can go back and check that out to get the definition of a node and an antinode because you are going to need that moving forward in this video. So in this video, we're going to look at a tube that is closed on one end and open to the air on another end. Now, guys, this is practical in things like organs or other musical instruments that have a tube with one side open. All right, now I'm pretty sure a flute is open on both sides, so that might be a little different, but you music people know sometimes we have a tube that's closed and then we have a tube that's open. And what happens is the sound that exits the tube is going to be the resonance of that sound wave. Now, sound wave, guys, are not transverse waves, they're longitudinal waves. But to help us on better understand this, I am going to draw them as transverse waves. So first, we have something that we are going to call the length of the tube, and it's going to run this way, L. And inside that tube, we are going to have a wave. Now, once again, I know that the waves of sound are longitudinal, okay? Their particles move parallel to the motion of the wave, but I'm going to draw them as transverse just to make our life easy. Now, when we cause resonance inside tubes, and remember, to cause a standing wave, that's essentially what we're doing. We're causing a standing wave inside a tube. We must have a node at the fixed end. So this right here is going to be the node of the wave. But unlike a transverse standing wave in a rope, I'll show you that just as a quick review, where we have a fixed end here. And to have that, we need to have nodes on either end. This is going to be a little bit opposite. We are going to need to have an antinode at the exit. So we need antinode here. And I'll try and draw this to the best of my ability. Okay, so now at the exit, we have the A. Now, this is very important for us to understand. I'm going to do a quick note. We could only have resonance for this kind of tube, if there's a node, there's one, a node at the fixed end, and also an antinode at the opening. Because you'll remember from strings, we had harmonic numbers that could be one, two, because we counted antinodes. And on a standing wave in a transverse, we had an antinode that was continuous. But here, we're going to find out that our end number can only be odd digits because I can't have n equals two for resonance. And I'm going to show you what I mean by that. We have to be able to identify how long in terms of wavelength is this wave. That's the first major hurdle that we need to understand. We see that from here to here, guys, this is one quarter of a wavelength. If you don't understand that, that's where things become very tough, right? Essentially, it's just this. This is the part of the picture that we're looking at if we look at a full wave. So there's a quarter, then we'd have a half, then we'd have three quarters, and then we'd have a full. So this is, we have L now equal to one quarter of a wavelength. So the wavelength of the first resonant frequency is equal to 4L. And since frequency equals V over wavelength, we could say that the first harmonic frequency is going to be equal to the velocity of the wave inside that tube times 4L. So these guys are the really important formulas that we need to be able to derive. That's correct. You do not get these formulas on the reference table. All you get on the reference table is V equals frequency times wavelength, or essentially this formula right here. So we are going to have to count the resonant number, which is going to be in this case the first resonant number, one, because there's one antinode that happens at the opening. And then we're going to have to use the L and compare it to how many one quarter wavelengths there are inside that tube. Now, this is the lowest, smallest one I can have, right? One node, one antinode. So this is going to be referred to as the fundamental frequency. All right, now this is essentially going to be when n equals 1. But what we're going to see for the next frequency, which they call the overtone, the first overtone, cannot be equal to n equals 2. The n numbers for sound waves inside a tube with a closed end can only go up by odd digits. Here's what I mean, and here's how we can show that. So here's a tube once again. Now remember, we can only have resonant frequencies when A is at the end. So in the last diagram, we had the open end was right here, and this was 1/4 of a wavelength, right? Because the antinode was at the end of the tube right here. If I add another 1/4 of a wavelength, I would have had a node at the end of the tube. That would not cause a resonant frequency. So what I had to do was I had to move even further another 1/4 of a wavelength to actually get that resonant tone to come out. And I still have L, this is the length of the tube. So I cannot have N equals 2. I would have N now is equal to 3 because I have 1, I have 2, and I have 3 1/4 wavelengths. So I would say that now the length of this tube is equal to 3 times 1/4 of a wavelength. So then wavelength is equal to 4 times L over 3. And the frequency then becomes 3V over 4L. Now the frequency, guys, that gets a little confusing for people. So let me just work that out real quick. So we know this from our reference table. If I take now F and I make it V over 4/3 L, I then can put this L up here. We're good to go. And that's how I came up with 3/4 of V over L. So once again, guys, these are all things that we need to be able to derive. So the pattern for this that we can either memorize or be able to derive is that the wavelength for any tube to find the resonance is going to be equal to 4L divided by the N number. But N must be odd. So for closed end, open end tubes, I can never have N equals 2, 4, etc. And the frequency can be found by saying that the N number is equal to V over 4L. And we could see that here. We had 4L over 3. And then the frequency, we had our N number was 3 times 1/4 VL. The fact that this needs to be odd, guys, is sometimes very confusing for students. And the reason is because we are going to work in factors of 1/4 of a wavelength. And because at N equals possibly 2, the even number, I would have a node. You cannot have a node at the end of an open tube. It will not make any noise. Let's do a quick example, and I'll show you exactly how a question might be asked using this tube. So this question says, a closed end tube resonates at a fundamental frequency of 440 hertz. The speed of this wave is 343 meters per second. What is the length of the tube and the next higher harmonic frequency? So the first thing that we want to see, guys, is when they say fundamental frequency here, what they're saying is N needs to be equal to 1. So when finding the length of the tube, we might want to go back to that first expression that we made where L was equal to 1/4 of a wavelength. And therefore wavelength was equal to 4L. But we can't use this formula to find L because we don't know wavelength. But we do know from our reference table that frequency is equal to V over lambda. So therefore we can find the frequency, we can use the frequency to say that V over 4L could then help us find the length L equals V over 4F. When we substitute in, we say that 343 meters per second divided by 4 times 440, ouch, that hurts. We can see that the L for this tube is going to be 0.195 meters long. That's how we solve for part A. Now for part B, the next higher harmonic frequency. So if we are currently at N equals 1, we have to figure out what the next harmonic frequency is. Now remember, for closed end tubes, N's only go up by odd numbers. So we cannot have N equals 2. It has to go by an odd number, N equals 3. This is our next higher harmonic number. Therefore, the next harmonic frequency is going to be N equal to 3. So 3 times F1 is going to be equal to 3 times 440 hertz, which is going to be equal to 1320 hertz. So this part B question is getting you to understand for you to show that you know that in a closed end tube, we cannot have N equals 2. In the next video, guys, I'm going to do a tube that is open on both ends. So look forward to that video as well.